Precious Paul Ellering.
Yes.
So Paul Ellering, I believe, actually started in the Memphis territory, and he hurt his knee in a match against Robert Gibson.
As you well know, for the past 6 months, Precious Paul Ellering has been recuperating from a very serious injury. But, Paul, it seems that you're back now and in better shape than ever and raring to go.
I can't believe it myself. Precious Paul, the living doll, the master of disaster, the master blaster. From 8 to 80, Precious drives him crazy. And I'm back, RB. Better and bigger than ever. Precious Paul's back. And back to stay, not back to play. Precious Paul's got a lot of lovely ladies out there, and he's got one main squeeze in mind. Precious Paul understands there's $1,000 floating out here in the stratosphere. Can you dig it, stratosphere? There's 1,000 big ones, and I got one big main squeeze in line. And she says, Precious Paul, I like 1,000 clamoroos. I know you give it away every day. And I say, lovely lady, it's so great to be great. Precious Paul loves the land of the free and the home of the footlong hot dog. Can you dig it, footlong hot dog?
Absolutely.
I don't even know what that means.
No one knows what it means, but it's provocative.
No, it's not.
It gets the people going.
And then hurt it again shortly thereafter, so he never really recovered from it. And Ole Anderson was the guy who figured out he had a mouthpiece on him and could use him as a manager.
Well, at least Gordon Solie, I have the option of looking bad. That's more than I can say for you, Ole Anderson. You look bad all the time.
I don't know how long it took, but he's eventually teamed with the Road Warriors. And the reason I wanted Paul Ellering on this list is because he wasn't just their on-screen manager. He took care of their travel, their money, their appointments, their timing, everything. He literally managed the Road Warriors.
Said, well, we're going to work for you, Vern, but we're not going to just work for you. We're going to work for the NWA, and we're going to work for any independents that want us. And that's where I became the showroom. We were an attraction. Like Andre the Giant was an attraction.
I will agree with everything you said. I won't add too much to it other than I got to see him wrestle when he was Paul. He went Paul to Bull Ellering at one time, had a tremendous physique. I knew he had gotten hurt, didn't know what happened. And when you sent me his name, I knew he needed to be on that list, and I think justifiably so. And also the fact that he handled their day-to-day activities, staying with that team for that long. I admire that in any sports organization.
You can't leave, you can't turn your back and walk away from it. So I never did. I always held out on them. So.
Read the book that has the literary and wrestling worlds on fire. Pin Me, Pay Me, Have Boots Will Travel, by accomplished professional wrestler Bobby Blaze Smedley. The incredible story of one man's battle to overcome all odds and realize a lifelong dream. Travel with Bobby in the ring, on the road, and around the world, including inside stories from WWE, WCW, Smoky Mountain Wrestling, and more. Forward to the book written by Jim Cornette. Buy your copy of Pin Me, Pay Me, Have Boots Will Travel on Amazon.com today.